like to grab your attention for a few moments. We're Christian preachers of the gospel of Jesus Christ, and we bring you good news today. We bring Oxford good news today. The good news that your sins, however great, can be forgiven. Your sins, no matter how far you've sunk it into the depth of your sin, into the depth of depravity of your wicked little heart, your sins can be forgiven. Even though God is a holy, righteous, and just God, and will do what's right on the day of judgment, your sins, every lie, every wicked word that's come from your lips, and every filthy thought that you has entered into your head can be forgiven. That's good news. So how can your sins be forgiven? 2,000 years ago, God himself, your creator, the one who knit you together in your mother's womb, the one who gave you life at a time of his choosing, he became a man. God became a man. He lived a perfect, sinless life, and he died a criminal's death. In his people's place, the wrath of God was poured out upon Jesus Christ. And he's the only way that your sins can be forgiven. Jesus Christ said, I am the way, the truth, the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. You cannot have your sins forgiven through your own efforts. Without the shedding of blood, there is no forgiveness of sin. Jesus Christ said, nobody takes my life. I lay it down freely and I have power to take it up again. He said it's finished when he gave up his life on the cross. And 3 days later, he resurrected himself back from the grave, proving to us that he is God who has power over death. Death could not hold him. The grave couldn't keep him. Jesus Christ is the only religious leader to be resurrected. He's the one who has power over death. And he's the one who can save.